What would you say is the critical thing that you would offer in terms of advice for someone that is interested in building a better network, how to leverage that attention towards that activity?
Well, again, it's about, well, first it's about making it easy, making it take as, you know, eliminating the speed bumps, making it be as easy as possible, creating a habit out of it. Just like you don't have to figure out a way to shower and eat every day, but somehow it's still, you just sort of work it into your day. Well, maybe not Drew, but most people. Just, you know, it somehow you just sort of, when you look at your schedule, you just sort of calculate that in unconsciously. That's really what a habit is. And so creating that out of the things that are really important to you, like leveraging your connections. But then where the attention really comes in is when you are with people, to really give them the gift of your attention. Because if you're on the phone or on your device or looking around the room when you're talking to somebody, they know it and they don't feel engaged with you at all. And it's a really big way to, for an activity that would normally strengthen your connections, to actually detract from your connections. Because people say, well, yeah, I saw her, but man, she was so rude. She wasn't even listening to me or whatever. So, but it's, you know, it's become so common now. People really think that it's just accepted that, you know, oh, I can look at this text while you're talking to me. That's just what we do now. But I think it shouldn't be what we do now. And I think there are a lot of people that still don't accept it and do think it's rude.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, I'm going to even go so far as to say I think some people watching this video right now are probably trying to multitask and do some other things and not paying attention to what you're saying.
I swear I'm not doing anything.
I'm sure that's true. It's one of the reasons a lot of clients or potential clients say, you know, can you deliver your training as a webinar? And I can say, you know what, I can deliver my training as a webinar, but your employees won't get any value out of it because they'll be reading their email and texting and doing everything else. And so they won't absorb any of it. And so if you really want me to, I will, but I don't recommend it.
That's good. What would you say about people that are you know, obviously with all these different channels, ways that we can build connections, you know, LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, all these various social networks. What advice might you give someone that's interested in building a better network and looks at these tools as a way to you know, grab more connections, right? You know, what advice might you have for someone that is looking at that and you know, suggestions you might have to, you know, help them focus on, you know, the right types of connections?
Yeah. It's a really interesting question, and I think that there are so many rules about social media, and I don't know that any of them are necessarily right, because it's still such a new technology and the rules are still really being written. A lot of people call themselves social media experts, but you know, I don't know that there really are any yet, because social media by definition is just this group of individuals who have all different opinions and all different feelings, and what some people might think is the right way to interact on social media might turn off a whole another, you know, segment of the audience that you're trying to be reaching. So on the one hand, I think that authenticity is really important, and engagement. So you have to be yourself. And you have to, and it has to be not all about you. But at the same time, I think you have to be your best self, because it's so easy to just, you know, throw out some sarcastic comment or to share something that maybe you do believe in, but could be really offensive to other people. And so, you know, and then there's this fine line between saying, well, I am who I am, and if anybody doesn't want to do business with me because of that, then that's their right. And I think that's valid. On the other hand, as business people, I think we want to reach as many. If you believe in what you do, like I know you are. Sorry.
Squirrel.
If you believe in your business, like I know you guys do, then you really want to try to reach as many people as possible with that business, And if you're going to turn off a whole segment of the population with like your political beliefs or anything else, then that can be a real challenge.
Sure.